Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create a powerful sci-fi movie poster inspired by the 1927 cinematic masterpiece Metropolis by Fritz Lang. I provided a Photoshop template that you can download so you can follow along. Its link is in my video's description or project files below. It includes this image of a mannequin's head, movie poster credits, and an image of electronic lines that we'll use later. Hide the top two layers and make sure the mannequin layer is active. The first step is to separate the mannequin from the white background. The quickest way to do this is to use the magic wand tool. Make its tolerance 5 and make sure contiguous is checked. Contiguous will keep the selection only on the background and not select any areas in the mannequin. Click anywhere on the white background. In order to ensure that there'll be no white fringe around our subject, go to Select, Modify, and Expand. Expand it by 5 pixels. To soften the edges of the selection, go back to Select, Modify, and Feather. Feather it 3 pixels. Invert the selection by pressing Ctrl or Command-Shift-I. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to our subject. We'll convert our image into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively. To do this, click the icon at the upper right corner and click Convert to Smart Object. The next step isn't absolutely necessary, but if you're using Photoshop version CC or later, we'll use the Liquify tool's Face Aware filter to make the eyes bigger and wider, as well as making the mouth frown a bit. You can skip this step if you're using a version earlier than CC. Go to Filter and Liquify. Make the Face Aware icon active and make sure Preview is checked. Click the icon to the left of Face Aware Liquify, and under the Eyes properties, click the chain link for the eye size. This links the left and right eyes. Drag either slider all the way to the right to make the eyes bigger. Do the same for the eye width. Drag the eye distance slider all the way to the right. In the mouth properties, drag the smile slider all the way to the left. Feel free to experiment with the other properties if you like. Then click OK. Make a new layer below the active layer by Ctrl-clicking or Command-clicking the new layer icon. In this empty layer, we'll create a simple Art Deco-inspired background. To start, we'll fill the empty layer with black. But first, check your foreground and background colors. If they are not black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. Since the foreground color is black, press Alt or Option plus Delete. Hide the mannequin layer, and to give us a bit more room, zoom out a bit by pressing Ctrl or Command and the minus key on your keyboard. To find the vertical center of our document, go to View, and make sure rulers and snap are checked. If they're not, just click on them to make them active. Go to the ruler on the left and drag out a guideline until it snaps to the center. If you don't see the guideline, press Ctrl or Command H. Click the foreground color to open the color picker. In the hexadecimal field, type in B353133. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. Open your Custom Shape tool and choose Pixels. If you're using CS5 or earlier, the pixel icon is here. Make sure its opacity is 100%. Open the Shape thumbnails and click the gear icon to open your list of custom shape presets. Click Symbols. When you see this message, click OK to replace your current shapes with the shapes from Symbols. Click this thumbnail, which Adobe calls Registration Target 2. Click the top gear icon, and make sure Define Proportions is ticked and From Center is checked. Place your tool on the guideline at the bottom of your document and drag it out until the shape is beyond the top edge of the black background. Then, release. Convert it into a smart object and go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 20 pixels. Hide the guideline by pressing Ctrl or Command H. Many vintage posters were lithographs that were printed on rough paper, so they had a rough paper visual texture. We can somewhat simulate that texture by going to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the Texture folder and click Texturizer. Make the texture sandstone, the scaling 100%, the relief 4, and the light from the top. Next, to make our movie title pop more, we'll add a soft dark gradient behind it at the top. Make a new layer, and make your foreground color black by pressing D on your keyboard. Open your gradient tool, and make sure the radial gradient icon is active. Open your gradient thumbnails, and click the black to transparent thumbnail. Press Enter or Return, and zoom out. If the magnification is not 25%, just type it in. Go to the top of your canvas, and press and hold the Shift key as you drag straight down to the bottom of your document. Then, release. We can zoom back in again. Make the mannequin visible and active. Make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J. To save space in the Layers panel, click this icon to collapse the smart filter. We'll make selections around the irises of the eyes so we can separate them from the rest of the face. To do this, zoom into the eyes by pressing Z on your keyboard to open your zoom tool and drag a rectangle over the eyes. Open your elliptical marquee tool and make sure the Add To icon is active. This will add selections as we make them. Click on the left pupil as you press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift. Drag out a circular selection just inside the iris and don't release. If you want to reposition the selection, add the space bar as well and drag the selection to reposition it. Then, release. Repeat these steps for the right eye. Go to Select, Modify, and Feather. Feather it 2 pixels. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selections next to the active layer. Temporarily hide this layer and make the original mannequin layer active. To fit the entire document onto your canvas, press Ctrl or Command 0. However, I'll zoom out a bit more. Click the background color to open the color picker and pick a bright red. Go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Close the Texture folder and open the Sketch folder. Click Reticulation. Make the Density 5, the Foreground Level 16, and the Background Level 22. We'll brighten our overall image by clicking the Adjustment Layer icon and clicking Levels. In the Input Highlights, type in 176. Next, we'll brush in black over the eyes. Make the red mannequin layer active and make a new layer above it. Open your brush tool and brush picker. Make the size 40 pixels, the hardness 0%, and the opacity and flow 100%. Brush over each eye to fill them in. To add the reticulation texture over the eyes, either press Ctrl or Command F or Ctrl Alt F on Windows or Command Option F on a Mac. Scroll up to the mannequin copy and make it visible. Make its layer mask active. Invert your foreground and background colors by pressing X on your keyboard so black is your foreground color. Open your zoom tool and zoom into the eyes. Press B to open back your brush tool. To adjust the brush size, press the right or left bracket keys on your keyboard. Click approximately here, release, and place your cursor approximately here. Shift-click, which brushes a soft diagonal line over the eye. Brush over the area above it to fill it in. Repeat these steps over the other eye, and then zoom back out. Scroll to the red mannequin and double-click the empty gray area to open its layer style window. Click Outer Glow and the color box. In the hexadecimal field, type in FF761B. Make the blend mode linear dodge, the opacity 30%, and the size 100 pixels. Click Inner Glow and the color box. Type in FF9C00. The blend mode is normal, the opacity is 30%, and the source is edge. The choke is 0%, and the size is 20 pixels. Scroll to the top and make the credits visible and active. Change its blend mode to screen. Make the electronic lines layer visible and active and change its blend mode to screen as well. Next, we'll add the movie title. Open your horizontal type tool and the font picker. You can pick any futuristic font you like, however, if you'd like to use the font I provided, type in Dissolve Regular. For the point size, I'll type in 89, Sharp, and Center Alignment. Click the box and pick White. Type out your text. Be aware that this particular font doesn't include numbers in its regular weight, so when you type in numbers, Photoshop substitutes it with a default font. However, Dissolve Light does include numbers. I'll highlight the numbers, type in the first few letters of the font name, and click the lightweight font. I'll type in 125 points for its size. If you want to slide the numbers up or down, click the character paragraph icon, or you can go to Window and Character. The character panel will open. Slide the baseline shift icon to the left or right to slide the highlighted text down or up. We can close the panel now. Open your Move tool and press Ctrl or Command A to select the document and click the Align Horizontal Centers icon. Then, deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command D. To slide the text up, press the up arrow on your keyboard. Next, we'll make our title glow. Double-click an empty area of the text layer to open its layer style window. Click Outer Glow and the color box. Pick white. Make the blend mode linear dodge, the opacity 40%, and the size 20 pixels. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.